Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our brother Ryker, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his.
Just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.
On behalf of the French family, I welcome you to the Lutheran Church of the Good Shepherd. I'm Pastor Taylor Wilson, and alongside Pastor Mary Simula Folkerds, we welcome you into this space to grieve, this space to reflect on life, this space to celebrate and remember the joy that Ryker brought to each and every one of us. We begin this time in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Ryker. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so that we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Continue with our scripture readings.
Our first scripture reading is from the Old Testament book of Lamentations. The word lamentation means sharing or expressing your sorrows. And this book of Lamentations is all about people who have gone through a terribly sad time. But in the very center of this book, there's these words of hope and words to remember that God is there. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. And then from the New Testament, we hear the love chapter of 1 Corinthians, chapter 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me.
Ryker Scott French, age 10, of Moorhead, Minnesota, passed away on Thursday, March 18th, 2021, at Sanford Medical Center in Fargo, North Dakota. Ryker was born April 22nd, 2010, in Grand Forks, North Dakota, to Timothy and Michelle Hall French. The family moved to Moorhead in 2012, where Ryker has grown up. Some of the things Ryker enjoyed most were being outdoors, spending time just soaking in the sun, riding fast in the boat, going for walks around Johnson Farms, and overnights in the fish house. He also enjoyed listening to music, watching movies, especially High School Musical, but most of all, he loved time with family, watching his sisters and brothers' events and snuggling his dog, Misha. Ryker is survived by his parents, Timothy and Michelle, sister Jaylee, brothers Bryson and Corbin, grandparents Scott and Becky Hall, and Robin Fenwick, great-grandparents Mildred French, Rena Twiss, and Howard Steinmetz, aunts and uncles Tyler and Macy Hall and their son Briggs, Thea Monteith, Vance French, Jesse Palacios, Renee Green, and Crystal Harrington. He was preceded in death by his grandfather Timothy A. French, great-grandparents Leland and Janice Hall, Arthur French, Marvin Twiss, and Naomi Steinmetz, and cousin Adam Steinmetz. Blessed be his memory. We are here today to remember Ryker, to be gathered together in the presence of God and know God's embrace. And as we gather today, we do three very important things. First, we come together and we grieve. It is hard to say goodbye. Death is hard to understand, and it's hard to let go. But we know that in the midst of these hard days, God is here, and so we grieve. The second thing that we do as we gather is we celebrate. In the midst of this hard goodbye, there are blessings. There are things to celebrate. There is the love of family to celebrate, the support of friends, the small triumphs of each day, the kind words being spoken, the hugs, and the unexpected ways that God will be showing up for you. We can celebrate these things as we remember Ryker. The third thing that we do, in addition to grieving and celebrating, is we see where God is. We look to God and God's promises to hold us up in these times. And we place ourselves and Ryker in God's care. Life is precious. We all know this, and you as a family know that life is precious. You have learned that over and over again with all your children, and especially with Ryker. In your time with Ryker, you knew struggle and you also knew joy. Ryker had a full life. Not the life that you imagined for him when he was born, but a rich and full life. The accident changed your lives and Ryker's life forever. But I firmly believe that God does not cause these accidents, nor does God will them to happen, but God does work through them. God has strengthened you to live the life that you have. And God finds ways to reach you and to give you the gifts you need along the way. I see God everywhere in your life story as a family. The love that you have for one another in your family, the friends that have come to surround you, your extended support system and support network, those are all gifts of God. God has given you meaningful work and meaningful activities and talents and energy, and all of these things are to be celebrated. And I believe that when we go through our most challenging times in life, we can see what love truly is. We can see the kind of love that is talked about in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. We see how love is patient and love is kind. We can see how love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. We see that love never ends. With God and with love, there is mystery, though. There are things that we cannot fully understand or comprehend on this side of life. There are mysteries that cannot be solved now. And that is why 1 Corinthians 13 ends by saying that faith, hope, and love abide, and that the greatest of these is love, and that God keeps on giving this over and over again. We have lost someone special. Ryker's death will be felt by all of you for a long time. And even though you've lost the same person, you all will grieve differently, and that's okay. So here are some ways that you can all show each other love during this time of grief. Be patient with each other. Be bearing of one another's burdens. Know that it's okay to spend time with friends, and it's also okay to have time on your own. It's okay to talk about your feelings, whether you're a kid or a grown-up. It's okay to feel sad. It's okay to feel like you need to blow off steam. It's okay to feel silly. It's okay to wonder why sad and hard things happen. It's okay to take walks and play sports. It's okay to listen to music. It's okay to take naps. It's okay to not feel like yourself or not know how you should feel. You can show love to one another by checking in with one another. And as the extended friends and support network for the French family, it's okay to check in. It's okay to bug them. It's okay to see how they're doing. And it's okay if they say they're not okay. Because grief takes time, and healing takes time. But as I said last night, I'll say again, God is big, and God is powerful. And I believe that God has one arm outstretched to hold all of you, to hold you up when you're feeling weak. And God has an arm around Ryker and around all the people who have died who are in God's care. God's embrace is big enough for all of us. I want you all to look at the front of your funeral program. On this, we have this beautiful Jesus stained glass piece, and it's actually behind you. So if you wanted to look at the real thing, you could turn your head around. But in this picture of Jesus, we see Jesus' arms outstretched. And underneath Jesus' arms, in Jesus' robes, it's actually the shape of a sheep on each side of Jesus in that negative space, where we see a sheep coming up close under each of Jesus' arms. It's hard to see it sometimes, but I want each and every one of you to know that you can be that one sheep on Jesus' one side, and Ryker and the other people that you love who have died are right there underneath Jesus' other arm. And Jesus' arms are big enough for all of us. Lean on Jesus' strong arms. Know that you are held in God's embrace, now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
As he sleeps, she goes in to hold his hand, and she tries not to cry as the tears fill her eyes. Can you hear me? Am I getting through tonight? Can you see him? Can you make him feel all right? If you can hear me, let me take his place somehow. See, he's not just anyone, he's my son. Sometimes late at night I watch him sleep. Dream of the boy he'd like to be. I try to be strong and see him through. But God, who he needs right now is you. Let him grow old, live life without this fear. What would I be living without him here? He's so tired and he's scared. Let him that you're there. Can you hear me? Am I getting through tonight? Can you see him? Can you make him feel all right? If you can hear me, let me take his place somehow. See, he's not just anyone, he's my son. Can you hear me? Am I getting through tonight? Can you see him? Can you make him feel all right? If you can hear is not just anyone. Can you
continue in a time of prayer. At the end of each petition, I'll say, Lord, in your mercy, and together we can respond, hear our prayer. We believe that Jesus meets us here in the midst of these. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, in your mercy, grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy. God, give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and certain hope. In the joyful expectation of eternal life with those that they love. Lord, in your mercy. Together let us pray as our Lord Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Ryker. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under God's wings, your refuge, with faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. You dash your foot up.